I'm finding that people that are struggling, it's a case of they no longer have the money to buy food, which then has an effect on their mental health. So the anxiety kicks in, the depression, they're living on basic things. One gentleman I went through, he's basically living on sweet tea because he had no food, nothing to help him survive.
And I've been here today talking about the impact of food poverty on people with a learning disability, and in particular how that can arise from the changes to welfare reform and benefits, and how austerity makes that a perfect storm where people can so easily fall through the gap. And the biggest impact that I've seen is the horrendous impact on the mental health of people when they're going through benefit assessments, which has a huge human and organisational cost to it and really needs to be addressed.
We've seen a huge impact of welfare reform on vulnerable people in our area. I coordinate North Liverpool Food Bank.
Well, at Farm Evan we produce greens, and one of the major things that we've researched is people's behaviour and response to food, and I just appreciate that when you're from a low situation, or if you're on benefits and money isn't guaranteed all the time, it's impossible to eat healthy, it really, really is. And so I think that there's so many people that are getting not the nutritional benefits from food because they're having to compromise on what they buy to be able to afford to eat.
I work very successfully with people, and the lot of people I work with are in poverty and have had a massive interaction with the benefit system, and through that they become unable to access any food. And I suppose where I'm coming from a psychological point of view, is that food is a basic human need, and actually if people aren't getting food and if people don't feel secure and safe with their food, then they're not going to be able to access effective mental health services, and that's where we can really see a decline or deterioration in people's mental health. And I mean, that is to do with the stress, the stigma, the shame that comes with having no money and no food, but also practical things, you know, how can you concentrate in a very obsession with starving or not worrying about how you can feed your children. It has a massive impact on people who are trying to access help. I think for me, it's really about linking different services together and trying to come up with a bit of a plan for people like me who are really passionate about this but maybe don't have all of the knowledge about where to send people or how to support people. So I think I would like to start working with this organisation to come up with a bit of a blueprint about how different services link together and where best we can help people get support.
I've learnt a lot about universal credit and I'm committed to praying for our department for work
pensions. Yeah, I think it's a lot to think about. We are trying to get the food that we produce into communities that need it the most, and by coming to this event and networking with all the wonderful people that have attended today, it's given me so many more ideas about how we can get food into the communities that need it most, who to work with, who's doing what already, and so that we can work together more holistically.
And as a result of today's event, we're going to think about how we make all of our communications accessible to people where they've got learning disabilities and background they're from. So to do that, we're going to go to an event organised by Feeding Liverpool on how to make communications easy for you.